So I want to leave you with one last topic that we have sort of set aside, which is very important, and that is the interreflection problem. So let's take a look at this simple object right here. It's being illuminated by a single point light source. So if you consider one point on the object, and I should mention up front that this object is a concave object, it's a cup. You're looking into the cup here. So let's say you're looking at this point right here. This point, of course, receives light from the light source. And in photometric stereo, we assume that the light that a surface point receives is only from the light source. But in reality, this point is going to receive light from all the points around it on the object. So all of its neighboring points on the object, which are not light sources, are going to receive light from the light source and then reflect some of that in the direction of this point as well. So this point receives light not only directly from the light source, but also from other points on the object. So the brightness of a scene point is not only due to the light source, but also due to light from other scene points. This is a harsh reality that we kind of set aside when we develop techniques like photometric stereo, because we don't have an obvious way to tackle the problem. We don't know the object as yet. We don't know what its shape is. And therefore, we have no way to actually tell exactly what these contributions to the brightness are from other points on the object. So as a result of this, when you apply photometric stereo, you have a concave object. And you, let's say, use three point light sources and you apply photometric stereo, what tends to happen is that the albedo values that you compute are going to be overestimated. They're going to be higher than they should be, which sort of makes sense because each point is reflecting more light than it should or it would if it had only received light from the sources. So the albedos end up being overestimated. In addition, the tilt of the surface with respect to the sources, the general tilt of the surface, also gets underestimated, meaning that the reconstructed surfaces end up being shallower than their actual shapes. These are two effects that come out of the fact that you have interreflections and we have ignored interreflections. So how do we deal with this? So here is a simple algorithm. This is the actual shape of the cup that we want to recover, and this is a Lambertian cup. When you apply photometric stereo, due to interreflections, you actually end up with this shape right here. We're showing a cross-section of the cup. As we said earlier, it ends up being shallower. That's the shape. So what you can do now is essentially use this inaccurate shape to estimate, get a first estimate of what the interreflections would be that are received by each point on the surface, and use those interreflections to correct the intensities produced by each one of the light sources, and then recompute the result of photometric stereo. And then once you get another shape there, you're going to repeat the process. So you keep going. You iteratively estimate the correct shape or a refined shape by taking into account interreflections in each iteration. So when you do that, you end up with a shape that looks like this. You actually converge to a shape that is very close to the actual shape. What we've seen here is a simple case of a Lambertian surface with a very simple geometry. In such cases, we can handle interreflections. We can account for them, compensate for them, and thereby recover a shape that's very close to the actual shape. But in general, I must say that interreflections pose a very hard problem. You're trying to recover a three-dimensional scene. Every three-dimensional scene has interreflections within it. But in order to know what those interreflections are, you actually need to know everything about the scene. So there's a bit of a chicken and egg problem here.